sacred space, sacred space. What do these words remind you of? A shrine, a temple, sacred space. Is a place in which there is the presence of the divine, the supreme being, or of a deity. A shrine is also very special, consecrated area, infinitely precious, connected to some highly significant event, or to a holy person. Shrine is usually located in a tranquil area. Can you imagine one? Let us for a while imagine the surroundings of this imaginary shrine. Call it a courtyard. Come to ourselves. What would you like to see in the physical surrounding of your own residence? Clean, of course, but perhaps embellished with colorful flowers, lovely shrubs, graceful creepers hanging over a pergola, a cozy swing under a shady, fragrant tree, a fountain gurgling nearby. Elegant birds flying to and fro from a bird feeder. All of these against beautiful, lofty background of a low range of evergreen hills. Large open spaces. Let your imagination run further and further. Feel the joy of being immersed in it, totally absorbed, tasting a heavenly pleasure, lost in the beauty and harmony of this ambiance of Mother Nature. Stay for a while, enjoying this state. Now come to yourself, the true self. And let us contemplate the idea that our faces, features, our outward personality is the courtyard of the temple of the body in which I am. This body, a human anatomy, a mansion made up of five elements of matter: the earth, water, fire, air, and space. A generous gift of nature. Yes. What do we see in the courtyard of the face? Let's observe our features and activities. How is this courtyard? Observe the contours very closely. See the profile of the features of the face. The lips gently opening into a lovely spontaneous smile of friendship, pure welcome, bright sparkling glow in the eyes, cheeks blossoming with the radiance of the natural happiness of the true being that I am, the real me. Gently unfurling like the petals of a beautiful flower, a sense of well-being oozing out a unique fragrance. The ears tuned to listening to the silent symphony of being one with all, with nature, with all creatures. Yes, one with all, deeply interconnected, interdependent, a general sense of belonging. I stay for a while, enjoying this eternal moment of pure harmony. Now I gently turn and move inside the temple. Who is this divine being in the magnificent temple of this body? Wow! I see, I feel, such a being of light, seeing without eyes. I see this invisible being of light, an all-powerful, all-embracing presence, so magnanimous, a divine energy. Presiding on the altar, my heart, you are a monarch with the radiance of 1,000 windows, opening on innumerable wealth of a breathtaking beauty, bliss, a myriad of divinities. Who are these divinities? Peace, immaculate purity, endless love, so gentle, so soft, each quality spreading an exquisite perfume, an uncommon elixir. Oh, what can I say? Such ethereal feeling enshrouding me. Such a loving kindness and a surge of compassion washing over all debris, nourishing, healing. Who are you? Wow, who are you? My heart recognizes you. You are the Great One, the Lord of all Lords, the Creator of the Universe, the Master. Such a subliminal light. You, my Father, the Eternal One, my own sweet beloved, whom I have searched since eons and eons. Such a light. Such magnificence. I feel drawn as a moth. I feel drawn further and further. I get lost. I disappear. I am one with you.
sweetness. Sweetness looks for the good in things, for at its heart is the conviction that good is somewhere there in everything. If only you have the patience to discover it. False sweetness is saying that something is good when you haven't taken time to really find out what it is, and so have lazily hit on something obvious to comment on. Real sweetness feeds only on reality. A bitter tongue makes life bitter. A sweet tongue makes life better. Bitterness is a result of disappointment and pain. To express bitterness is to reveal my own inner hurt. When I realize that my words have become bitter, I can bring sweetness into my mind. All I have to do is to remember a pure intention, the innocence of a happy moment, or just to remind myself of how sweet I truly am inside. Today, let me bring sweetness to life. Anthea Church.
with sweetness. Give a vision of closeness to the Father. Sweetness in your thoughts. Sweetness in your words. And sweetness in your actions is closeness to the Father. This is why the Father says every day, "Sweet, sweet children." And the children respond, "Sweet, sweet Baba." Therefore, these sweet words every day make you sweet. Let your words have love, sweetness, and greatness. Let there be truth and also humility in you. Be fearless and speak with authority, but also stay within the codes of conduct. Let there be a balance of both of these. Where there is balance, wonders are seen, and then the words spoken do not feel bitter, but sweet. So show the wonder of balance, of having both authority and humility. This is the means of revealing the Father. To the extent that you have intoxication in your intellect, accordingly, also have humility in your actions and sweetness in your words. By having such intoxication, there will never be any damage. Those who achieve success will make themselves humble-hearted. They will be full of sweetness and they will pick up virtues from every situation.
Remembrance makes you sweet. Avyakt Bapdada came into the gathering of the children and gave sweet drishti to everyone. In the father's mind is my sweet children. And in the children's mind is my sweet Baba. The meeting of the father and the children is so pleasant, so sweet. For how long do you remain in remembrance of Baba? That which is sweet is automatically remembered. Who constantly moves along with the waves of the ocean of sweetness? He is the most sweetest. You have to remember that sweetest father with a lot of love, because the father says, children, it is only by remembering me that you will become sweet. This is the saccharin of knowledge. Even one drop of saccharin is so sweet. Similarly, even one word of knowledge is man man above. It is sweeter than everything else. The sweet father becomes your guide and takes you back to the sweet silence home from where we souls came. He then gives us the kingdom of sweet heaven. With sweetness, now make this bitter land sweet. Then you will go home to the sweet home and then to the new world. This is the sweet fruit of the confluence age.